course. Everybody knows Reverend Brown. Amos, you all were coming because just as John and I were going out the door, we got an email from a phone call from the lawyers on the other side said, hey, we're not going to go forward on Thursday. So we have maybe just a little breathing room, but this battle is not over.
Yes.
Tenants are here.
Yes.
They are concerned.
Yes.
They should be concerned. Arnold Towns is here. So this battle goes forward, but thank you all for your great support. And I know Mayor Brown and Reverend Brown all have words to say, Supervisor Breed. And
Supervisor Breed, I think you're next.
Hi everybody, I'm London Breed. I'm the supervisor for District 5. I grew up in District 5. I grew up with the families who are in this situation, and I am going to do everything I can to make sure that I protect affordable housing, not just these 104 units, but affordable housing throughout my district and throughout this city. We don't have the luxury to lose this housing. There are families, there are people's lives at stake. When we talk about a situation where no process occurred, no conversations with the residents, nothing happened to make them alert of exactly what was going on here. I got phone calls and emails and from my friends who are scared that their mothers and their sisters and their family members are gonna lose their housing. What kind of nonprofit organization does this to people? This is not gonna happen in this city. In this day and age, we have people who are stepping up to the plate. This property was built by Third Baptist Church and people from this community. We are not gonna let anyone rob us of our affordable housing. We work too hard. And so today is a small victory, but there is more fighting to be done. We still have to do everything we can to stick by the residents. We can't think that because they said we're gonna wait that we can sit idly by and allow them to do what they wanna do. We have to look at every legal parameter of what we can do to make sure that this affordable housing stock is not lost to the folks who depend on it, the folks who live there, the folks who grew up there. So we got work to do, and I want to thank Reverend Brown and Louise Rennie and John for just really coming together and filing this order to stop this sale. It's a small victory. We got more work to be done, and I just want the residents to know we are with you. We are standing together. Miss Givens, where'd you go? She went hiding around here somewhere. You should call. Okay, Miss Betty. Okay. We are here. I'm going to be meeting
here.
Miss Betty, I'm going to be meeting with the residents. I know a lot of folks are providing support. And again, thank you, Reverend Brown, for taking leadership on this and to make sure that we protect this housing. We got much work to do. Thank you, Mayor Brown, for being here and for continuing to stand up for African Americans in this city and our affordable housing in this city. We got work to do. Let's keep fighting. Let's get this done.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you to my colleague Scott Wiener for continuing to be an ally on the board and support our policies to make sure that we protect tenants in our city and protect affordable housing in our city. Thank you.
All right, next up we have Preston Turner, who is the head of the board of directors of the church.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Preston Turner. I am the chairman of the trustee board at Third Baptist Church. First of all, thank Mayor Brown, our supervisors, for being here, and thank you for your support. I can tell you that I was a member of that board of directors for 20 plus years. I was voted out. I was voted off that board in March of this year. The real reason is because I was standing up for right. I was standing up for justice. They stacked the deck. They voted me off. We need your help. We cannot afford to lose this housing for our seniors, for our grandmothers, for these families. We need to regain control of this board and put it back in the hands of Third Baptist Church.
Yes,
we need your help.
Yes.
We ask and we call on the Attorney General, the mayor to supervisors, and if we have to go to our governor, we want our governor to also take the charge and help us declare the victory.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Next up, we have Reverend Arnold Townsend, who is a resident of Frederick Douglass.
This is real important to me. I live there, and as I've expressed, this is not some political football. It's not an opportunity for a few folk to make some money.
Yes.
These are our homes.
Yes.
When too much gets on us in the world, this is where we go. And to have to come here and confront this is absurd. You need to know that there were some great people in this community. The late Mary Helen Rogers, Mr. Leroy King, we memorialized on last Saturday. The late Mr. Crenshaw, and I could go on. These folk laid down in front of bulldozers and sued to force redevelopment to build this housing. Every right that we have in this city was gifted to us in blood by the pioneers, and we will not allow these folk to put all these out of town.
They're saying
that after this, my unit could go for $3,000. Yes. Brother Townsend is in Vacaville if that happens.
Yes.
I don't drive well anymore. I can't afford to go to Vacaville. But we've got to stay vigilant, because one of the things you've got to know and understand, in this city, and it's happening in other cities, we live in the first period in history where the wealthy covet the homes and the neighborhoods of the poor. Let me say that again. The wealthy and the powerful covet the neighborhoods of the poor.
Yes.
And when people with money and power want what you have, you're in trouble. If Atlanta is no longer 50% black. Washington, D.C., Chocolate City, is no longer 50% black. And they're learning it from us. So now let's teach them how to turn it around. Let's continue the fight. Let's not go to sleep, because they pulled it off today. It's going to continue. Thank you.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
All right.
This is a petition from the residents.
No, for the residents.
For the residents.
Sunday Eagle Sasser meeting, Tim Rapper. My name is Wilfred Osserman. I live in the Western Division of Camp since 1960. Petition that is designed to be circulated within the development, so every resident in the development can sign it. Read the following. As a current resident of Frederick Douglass Haynes Gardens, a 104-unit affordable housing development that was developed by a nonprofit corporation created by Third Baptist Church in the 1960s, with an initial board of directors that for many years was composed of trustees of Third Baptist Church. I hereby sign this petition to express my full support of the efforts of the Third Baptist Church and the African American community of San Francisco to end the illegal assumption of ownership and authority to sell Frederick Douglass Haynes Gardens by the current illegal board of directors, who are acting in the absence of proof of any legal transaction that was ever consummated between themselves and Third Baptist Church that transferred ownership of Frederick Douglass Haynes to them, who as a group now illegally purport to have the ownership and authority to make the decision to sell Frederick Haynes Douglass Gardens by their board of directors. And they do not have legal ownership of the development being sold, and has not engaged in any consultation with the pastor or officers of Third Baptist Church to initiate a sales transaction process to sell Frederick Douglass Haynes Gardens. Let's stop this cop robbery immediately.
Thank you so much.
That's what I'm suggesting.
I think we might have a word or two from Mayor Brown.
Give it up for Brown.
Yes, sir.
Come on,
sir.
Come on. One more year. Come on.
You have no idea how really pleased I am that so many of you have shown up to do what we regularly do in San Francisco. When I heard 5 days ago about what was about to happen to Haynes dwellings of 104 families that live there, I immediately got on the telephone and started calling friends and relatives and cousins and what have you from every community, not just from African American. I recall Leroy King's family talking to Norman Fong, who runs Chinatown Community Development Operation. This city is replete with really talented, action-oriented people who really want to protect housing. London said it best when she laid out to you how diligent we have to be to make sure this happens. Because you see, it's only the tip of the iceberg.
Yes. Yes.
There are at least a half a dozen other properties similarly situated. How do I know that? Because I was part of the legal team that helped put these projects together back in the 60s when HUD was trying to do something to make sure housing was available to people, and people who could not afford it. Let me assure you, although Arnold Townsend referenced $3,000 that would be charged to him, he is not paying anywhere near that amount of money for where he is currently living. And believe me, as I said last night, unless you want Townsend kind of moonlighting your couch with you, you ought to be dedicated to doing this on behalf of the Townsends of the world and a whole host of other people.
Yes.
The next one in line is probably going to be Freedom West.
Yes.
And there are some 348 families that will be affected by Freedom West in that regard. Believe me, if this is established as the foundation and the action that will be taken by all of you, I guarantee you, somebody will figure out maybe they don't want to confront you. And although Mayor Lee is not here, having been a person over the years that made sure that in Chinatown nothing of this nature would ever occur, I'm certain that he's equally as proud as I am today of all of you and of what the Rennie firm has done and the kind of support that you are evidencing. Because after all, when you talk about affordable housing in San Francisco, you're really talking about the most cherished commodity, the most needed commodity that there is. And when London Breed said last night about this very issue, it would, she said, be very clear, if necessary to save it, we will have the city and county of San Francisco buy this property. And that was an incredible announcement, because believe me, she and the mayor can ultimately achieve that. So make sure every time you even hear that you might be needed, show up and bring some other relatives.
Boy, it's hot out here this afternoon. I am inexpressibly happy to say that on this corner today, we have witnessed the demonstration of a team effort. You do know that the Giants won because their mantra was, we were a team. I thank God that helping to lead this team of defense was our former mayor, who as a historian, I don't believe in redaction. I believe in telling the truth. And if the truth be told, we are here today because several weeks ago, I called on our illustrious former mayor. And I had in the back of my mind when I spoke with him that it was on January the 12th, 1865, that upon General Sherman and Secretary of War Stanton having burned down Atlanta and made it maybe hotter than it is today, and they left Atlanta marching to the sea, when they got to Savannah, Georgia, Secretary of War Stanton asked General Sherman, "What do we owe these ex-slaves who have followed us all the way to the sea?" He said to him, "Let's call the black preachers together." And General Sherman issued a call to 20 black preachers of an interdenominational aggregation who met in the General's Hotel. And he asked an old preacher, 60 years old, who had been preaching for 40 years, Garrison Frazier, "What do you feel the Union owes your people?" Brother Frazier spoke up and said, "General, I cannot speak for everybody here. But as for me and my house, at least we ought to have some of this land that we've been slaving on. Why can't we have 40 acres and a mule so that we'll be able to build our homes? We will be able to grow our crops. We will be able to build institutions and educate our children and live together in dignity and in freedom." From that conversation, my friend, Field Order number 15 was announced, setting aside 20 acres and a mule for all of these ex-slaves from Florida up to South Carolina. But you know what happened. We never got our 20 acres and our mule because that man Johnson from Tennessee succeeded President Lincoln after he was unfortunately assassinated. We ended up in doing sharecropping and that penal system that caused us to suffer economically, socially, and politically. I say to you in San Francisco, Somebody tried to snatch back our 40 acres and our mule. And the enemy this time was not from afar, but an enemy from in our own ranks,
yes,
who
yes.
got in cahoots,
yes.
with some crooked,
yes.
profiteering investors who are trying to snatch these people away from their homes. I thank God we got a team,
yes.
that's
yes.
going to fight on.
Yes.
We know we just crossed one river, but we got other rivers to cross.
Okay.
But we're going to cross over,
yes.
because we got Louise Rennie here.
Yes.
We're going to cross over,
yes, sir.
Because we got John Holzman here.
Yes, sir.
We're going to cross over,
yes.
because we got Brother Shaw here.
Yes,
we are going to cross over,
yes.
because Willie Brown Jr.,
yeah.
build the bridge that we're crossing over. And we're going to come to that day that this development that was named for Frederick Douglass Haynes Sr., an elegant preacher, the first black to run for the Board of Supervisors in 1947. We cannot let his legacy be stomped on, be trampled, and insulted by this kind of ignorance. Fight on! Hang in there!
Yes.
Victory's gonna be ours,
yes.
because we have got a team to take back that which belongs to us.
Yes. Woo. Woo.
All right, so it's time for any questions. One thing I did want to point out before questions, this is the actual email offering F.D. Haynes for sale. You'll note at the bottom the price.
prices that are listed for the properties, which are obviously not affordable housing prices.
We also have handouts of this document, which Eddie, Whitfield, will you raise your hand? Eddie has copies of this, and anybody who would like it, we'll hand it out to. But if media would raise their hands first, we'd like to make sure that media get copies of it. We also have copies of the news release, which we have not yet sent out, which I'll be glad to hand out at this time, if members of the media would raise their hands.
Emily, do you have one?
Any news media haven't gotten it?